honest.
Thank you.
What are your initial thoughts
tonight? Well, I mean, not to break it down into something so small, but I really thought it was all rebounding. We defended okay in the first half. We had some breakdowns, but 43% is what we held them to. We shot 46, and we gave up 12 offensive, and I think we were down, what was it, 25-11 in rebounding in halftime? 26-15. So we were down 11, and we finished down 4. So I just thought that was a big factor. Like, if we just felt like the few stops we got, whether we were in man or zone, we just didn't finish the possession with the basketball, and it seemed to really hurt us. And I think once we shored that up in the second half and shared the ball a little bit better, I think we had 4 assists at half, and we had 3 of them in the first 3 minutes. So we played 17 minutes with 1 assist. We kind of stopped sharing the ball. It kind of felt like the ball kept stopping, and we just didn't get it going enough until somebody was going to try and do something, and then that guy didn't really look to read off the help and make the extra pass to get to get the wide open shot. And we took some tough ones, or we turned it over driving into the help or running people over. So wasn't a very smooth first half, really. But I thought our second half was pretty good. I thought we defended hard, outside of probably fouling a little too much, especially with the lead. But give credit to those guys. Whiteside's about as about as good as it gets as far as what you have to guard. I mean, the dude can put it in the hole a lot of different ways, and quick, athletic. So proud of our guys' effort, and especially to come back second half after a little bit of a lackluster first.
What are your thoughts on the dynamic of this team without a Quantre Taylor, without a Montrezl Roberts, with what you have on the floor at your disposal?
Yeah, I mean, obviously it changes things for us in so many ways, but it also changes it for the other team as well. You know, all of a sudden – I've got Richard and Boog out there behind the 3-point line. You know, I thought last Saturday that was an issue for Catawba. You know, having guys out on the perimeter today, maybe not as much, but we had a few chances where we took. I thought Boog had a couple of really nice drives, and you know, instead of being guarded, you know, by a 4, he's guarded by a 5, and now he's got a chance to make some plays off the bounce a little bit. But then you got to throw back, would we have given up so many offensive rebounds in the first half if Quantre was on the floor? Probably not, because that's what he does well. So we'd love to have him back soon. I think we need him. But tonight we're just piecing things together right now, trying to figure. I mean, we got three, four minutes out of Vern, like, you know, and they were good. They were really good minutes, and you know, he probably had no idea, but we just didn't have a choice. We had to find one more guy could give us some minutes, and he did. You know, we had both those guys, Boog and RJ, kind of in foul trouble all night. So, and that's kind of it's just what we're gonna have to do until, you know, we get everybody back healthy.
How do you feel like your guys handled, you know, going through all those foul troubles with Pringle, with Boog, with Tuck? How do you feel like the dynamic changed? I understand you mentioned not having Fontrez, and Quantre had to go really small. How do you feel like they adjusted?
Yeah, I think they did a nice job, because if you think about it, there was a lot of minutes where we were really small in the second half, and we rebounded better in the second half. So, you know, size is great for rebounding, but you know what? It's all about the effort, you know? I mean, I think, Dennis Rodman's one of the greatest rebounders ever, and at his best, weighed 200 pounds maybe. He wanted the ball. You got to want the ball, and you got to be physical. And so that's kind of Quantre's trait, that he is physical. But our guards wanted the ball, and we did a lot better job from that aspect in the second half.
We know Jaron Cottingham can score the ball like this, but in this game, did he show you anything that you were like, oh, wow, like that's something I may not have seen before, and he took X or Y to another level?
No. So I've seen all that before. I like seeing it, but I will be able to show him the videotape and how it could have actually been a little better. You know, there was finished the first half. You know, that was a big play. You know, we should have got a bucket to finish the half, and instead we give up a 3-point play going the other way. So, but no, I think with Jaron, I've seen pretty much what he can do, and he doesn't, believe it or not, doesn't surprise me very often. But you know, he was dynamic in a stretch and really got to the rim and finished for a long stretch that really kind of separated us and gave us a little breathing room down the stretch, and especially while we were dealing with foul trouble, allowed us to have a little flexibility and take a chance and maybe go really, really small, because we were looking at a double-digit lead and could we stretch it a little bit. So, but yeah, I mean, Jaron made some great plays tonight, but I thought, I thought we had a lot of, especially second half, I thought we had a lot of great hustle plays and winning plays. And, you know, Tuck's a guy that I'm amazed sometimes how he comes up with the basketball. Like he just shouldn't, you know, he just shouldn't. And he just does, he kind of wills himself to it. So, you know, and that was kind of what we needed. You know, they score the ball. I told these guys, they can score the ball. They scored the ball all of last year. They went to Tusculum and scored 96. And a year ago, I think we scored like 40 at Tusculum. So don't think that they can't put the ball in the basket. And I thought as the game wore on, we got better at that.
Donald Nixon is, just impressive with what he's been able to do these two games since nicked up a bit before that. What is your biggest takeaway from him through the two games he's put out there on the floor?
Yeah, I mean, and he's still really not practicing. So, you know, obviously, as good as it's been, you know, we're hoping maybe he'll even get better after he gets all the way back healthy. But, he deserves it because it was a tough break. He was practicing as well as anybody before he got hurt. So, and kind of came back with a little bit of a different attitude and was doing things defensively that I didn't think he did a year ago, was being more aggressive offensively. And I think, and when he's on the floor, you really – it's a, you know, I know people look at him and think, geez, he's not very big, but he's going to make it hard for you, you know, because you got to come way out to guard him, and then he's lightning quick. So – he's given us an extra dimension at the guard spot right now, and it's good to have him back. We missed him in those first two, especially seeing as much zone as we played against. We could have used one more guy that could knock down a shot. So, but yeah, he's doing everything that we ask, and just kind of hope that we get through this next little stretch and get him all the way back to 100.
One more, Coach. The last two games, 90 plus points and 100 points plus points in the one before this one. What type of level do you believe your offense is playing at right now? How would you describe it?
We scored 98 tonight. I don't know that I really liked a lot of how we did it in the first half. And one of the things that we did, you try never to. You can get a little bit of a hangover from an 18-for-36 3-point game. So what we tried to do was we tried to show them that it was 18-for-36, but it was 35 great. We took one bad three, and that was only because of the shot. But we took 35 like wide open catch in rhythm threes, and that's why you made 18. Not that you just made 18, and I didn't think we did that as well tonight. So now we scored. Because a couple guys can make some plays and score, but I didn't like it as well. And I think if we can get a little bit more unselfish, I'm complaining about offense after 98, but I didn't like how some of them came. I thought they were outside of the flow of the offense, and then it And then you're kind of putting yourselves at the mercy of you being individualistic. And if you don't make the play, then it's going to be a bad possession. So, but I think if we'll do that, and we did it a lot more second half. I think obviously we got some great looks in the second half, and then once that started happening, the floor opened up a little bit more because you know all of a sudden you share it a few times, and the help guys stop getting so deep because they've given up a couple. And so I think if we can continue to share it and play for each other, you know, I use the phrase a lot that it's kind of, you know, they look at me sometimes, but it's got to be a little bit more organic. Like if you're just trying to make it happen, a lot of times it's a struggle, but if you just let it happen, we finally got to that, I thought, in the second half. If we can do that, I think we can put points on the board.
All right. Thanks so much for your time and good luck on Saturday.
All right. Thanks, guys.